it's easily forgotten that there was a time when black female friends existed.
Hey guys, I'm Antoinette Robertson and I play Coco Connors on Dear White People, and this is the What Had Happened Was after show. Today I am joined by the gorgeous Nia Gervier, who plays Kelsey, and the amazingly talented Logan Browning, who plays Samantha White, my BFF slash foe. But today we're talking about black sisterhood. And before we get into that, let's get into these drinks. This is called the sangrias.
Oh, yeah.
You have to do like, wait, sangria. Ooh, hair.
Oh, there's a hair flip.
Holla, holla, holla. Okay.
Let's do it.
5, 6, 7.
Sangrias. Cheers.
In the eye.
In the eye.
In the eye. The eyeballs.
Guys, let's talk about how different season 2 is when we're talking about sisterhood.
First of all, when you think about season 1, you and I are like at odds, right? But then they do go through our flashback story and show how we became friends.
Yeah. I think it just kind of shows the fact that like friendships are roller coasters.
Right.
Like you're gonna love your best friend today, you're gonna hate her tomorrow, you guys might be frenemies, and then you might, you know, have a kumbaya moment and then you're BFFs, you know? But I think this season specifically, we talk about how girls need to support each other through tough times. And I think that's really beautifully displayed by Nia Gervier as Kelsey.
Kelsey?
Mm-hmm.
I think this is a good time to let you know I'm strictly dickly.
Don't flatter yourself, love. Trinnies just consider this a very delicate time for a woman.
It's so wonderful to see the Coco-Kelsey dynamic.
Mm-hmm. It's very interesting, because in season 1, we knew each other. But
yeah.
I don't know. There's something extra
special. We kind of sort of went to the same school. We may have had the same white friends.
Most definitely.
Most definitely had the same white friends, but that's it.
But in sisterhood, it ebbs and flows, and whether or not you weren't really friends in season 1 or you knew each other as freshmen, and it's still, the sisterhood remains even though you might be frenemies.
Yeah, that's something that you don't see a lot. Like, that's a specific relationship where these two people actually don't get along.
Yeah.
Like, they don't vibe at all, but they're not tearing each other down.
No.
And they put that aside when it counts to show up for the sisterhood. That's like, it makes it more like family.
It does.
The sisterhood makes your friendship a family.
Because that's authentic.
Yeah.
Your relationship with your family, you can't control them. Oh. You can't control who you're related to. We know that. We can drink to that one.
Drink to that. Toast to that. Are we
Toast
doing a hair
to
flip?
Ooh,
every time.
Yes.
Sangrias.
So how do we feel about seeing the representation of black women is way more prevalent than it's ever been?
Absolutely.
And now we're starting to see the dynamics of our relationships. How do you guys feel about that?
I think it's a testament to showing that what we see in the media and on TV is more reflective. It's becoming more reflective of who we really are as people.
Yes.
So as they show us as like layered or real people that have different variations and different backgrounds, then you can also expose the sisterhood and not just
the catty
reality TV with
girl.
All of the catty, like, neck-popping, lip-smacking stuff. That's not good.
Let's talk about the end of chapter 4, where Coco has to make some really tough decisions and how having the abortion affected, you know, her perception of where she could go in the world and why she believed that having a child so young was going to inhibit her growth.
And also the fact that you didn't have to do it alone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That well, you went Coco
yeah.
did it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Kelsey was right there.
I know.
You guys are cute. I was so jealous that you guys had this whole, like, bonding experience.
It was really, we had an entire
so
day
fun.
Where just the two of us were on set.
It was just us.
For 18 hours.
Yeah.
That is a very sensitive topic.
Oh my
it
gosh.
Is a stigmatized topic. It's a political topic. You know, it's an emotional topic.
Yeah.
And this
show. And rarely spoken about in the black community.
Oh,
yes.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Your entire episode, like the fact that you went through, this is what my life would be in this way. I mean, you really, it was very fully fleshed out in terms of what her options were. And I think that that's also a really important part about, just women in general and the topic
to
of
show
our
that you
bodies
have options.
And
yeah.
And that like moment where like you said where you get to see what her life would be like if she decided to have her baby and what it would be like if she didn't.
I think a brilliant display of sisterhood was when Sam's father passes and Coco and Joelle go to be there for her.
The last time I talked to my dad, I didn't even let him finish his sentence before I hung up on him.
Yeah, but no one expects to finish a sentence around you.
You just lost your dad. Don't beat yourself up over a phone call.
He deserved so much better.
So, this season, I'm really gonna try not to cry. So you guys know my personal, like.
Should I get closer to you?
Oh my God, I'm not gonna cry. Why did they just say that and all of a sudden, okay, anyway. Okay. But seriously, Joelle and Coco, like, being there for Sam was literally what I remember my two best friends, Joy and Saida, doing when I lost my dad. And it was just like, it was this innate thing they knew. Yeah. And I feel like Coco and Joelle knew that they needed to be there for Sam. I mean, it's super fun. I mean, that's a crazy word, but it's the first time you leave Winchester.
Yeah.
You know, that episode was so beautiful to see that. And the different ways that they helped her cope. Mm-hmm. I think that's something really beautiful about women and Black women is we all have different ways of assisting each other, you know? Sometimes good, sometimes bad even, you know, sometimes assisting and helping can be in the form of physical affection and being there for someone. And sometimes it's like, toughen up, sister. Like, I know you have more in you.
Sometimes you just want your friends to make you laugh and forget about what's going on.
Well, even sometimes people don't know they need it, you know? We isolate ourselves because sometimes you don't think people care about your problems. And, and two, you don't want to bother people. Like, as Black women, we're so concerned with being what is the word? Being an inconvenience.
Yes, like you don't want to inconvenience someone.
You don't want to inconvenience, and you don't want to put the caregiver role on someone else because you know what it's like.
Yeah.
And so we're constantly like, I got it. I'm good.
Yeah.
And so for our friends to show up like the Kelseys, like the Cocos, like the Joelles, that's really what women should take from this season.
The bottom line is barrel your way in, just show up.
And they need to take from the fact that none of us have it together.
None of us. No one does.
We're all a mess. I had a wonderful time with these ladies.
Me too.
And I'll drink to that.
Yes.
Sisterhood and everything else. Mm. Cheers.
Boop. Love you guys. Boop. I love you. If you don't
know,
I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
You already know.
You know I love you.